Hello, good morning. Please have a seat so we can stop that bell. We're gonna start. So welcome everyone to Privacy Camp 2024. I'm Claire Fernandez. I'm the Executive Director of EDRi, European Digital Rights. EDRi is one of the co-organizers of Privacy Camp, together with the VUB LSTS, Privacy Salon, the Institute of European Studies of the University Saint-Louis. And we are welcoming also this year two new institutional partners, the Institute for Information Law of the University of Amsterdam and the Racism and Technology Center. So welcome, everyone. We have, it's the 12th edition of Privacy Camp, and that means Privacy Camp is entering its adolescence. And it's, you know, moved from being a pre-CPDP activist-free conference to being one of the most influential events in Brussels to discuss digital policies. And as present-day teenagers, it's developed new features like a new website and streaming online so that more people can enjoy the content. But it's also building its identity in times of turmoil and existential crisis. So Privacy Camp is also a community of friends and of supporters that understand and want to reflect on the impact of technologies on society, whether it's old-timers or newcomers. So I would like to have a show of hands if you've attended more than 10 Privacy Camps. Of course, the one and only Kirsten Fielder. Actually, 12, I think. More than 5? Yeah. All right. Is it your first one? All right. Well, welcome to everyone, and thank you so much for joining us. So this year's topic was an invitation to really investigate the systems that are shaping the field of privacy and data protection, digital rights, whether it's technical systems, political, societal systems. And we wanted to have conversation that talk about transformational systemic change. And I have to admit, it feels good because in Brussels, as many of you would know, we kind of fatigue around the current context. Social change feels a little bit stalled. And we really need more political conversations challenging the responses of Europe to the current crisis. So many of us will feel discouraged, anxious, or just really disturbed about the European Union responses to the challenges we face, whether it's the climate emergency or seeing the double standards in which the President of the European Commission will show when it comes to the ongoing violence in Israel and Palestine. So because technology can amplify this crisis, and because technology is not a silver bullet to these issues, it felt important to discuss that today. And I'm really glad that we have really bold conversations and that your submissions were really excellent this year. So really looking forward to discussions on digital exclusion, on data centers, on health data, on big tech power, on migration and surveillance, the gig economy, extractivism, decolonizing practices for the field, wartime surveillance, and the enforcement of privacy and data protection legislation. In this year of democracy, where many people will go vote around the world, we also felt it was important to discuss what are the digital futures we want to see. And EDRi has attempted to do that with its own manifesto around the EU elections, of course, but we wanted to be bringing the vision that we have for technologies that serves humanity, democracy, and the planet. So I'll leave you explore online on the EDRi website what that looks like in practice, but essentially looking at four big visions that are accompanied with more detailed policy positions, which of course we will continue developing looking forward. We want a technology that is empowering people to flourish and to thrive. We want technologies that prioritize planet care, systems that prioritize safety, participation, and community care rather than surveillance and control, and technologies that are for, by, and of the people rather than centered around profit and innovation. And it really feels important, while there are current political parties that are putting their visions, talking about getting rid of privacy or centering just innovation and security, it does really feel important that there is an alternative vision from all corners of civil society. So we can't do that alone. I would encourage you, if you want to reach out and see how you can support us in amplifying that vision, and you can reach out on our website. A few thank yous, and then finally some practicalities before we can start. First of all, I want to thank our partners, and to begin with, the general partners of this event, the European Data Protection Supervisors. So a big round of applause for the team of the EDPS. It's the seventh year in a row that they're supporting the event and holding the EDPS Civil Society Summit within Privacy Camp. And this year is a special year also for the EDPS. They're turning 20. So I think they, for those who want to continue the party, there will be a celebration of Data Protection Day tomorrow and an event, I think, that's open. Many of you will attend. We also look forward to the June summit talking about democracy and the role of privacy in democracy. We, you know, Privacy Camp will not be happening without the general support of EDRi funders, whether institutional or individual. So in order for the events to continue being free of access, we would encourage you, if you can, to donate to EDRi and to partners. You have the ability to do so with various posters in the space. This edition in particular was supported by Surfshark, TechHive, Mojik, and Cobbler. And now, thank yous for people. So first of all, the content committee of the event. So raise your hand if you're already here, and we will know who is and who is not this time. Andrea Bellu from EDRi. Gloria Gonzalez from the VUB. Is Gloria around? Not yet. Rocco Bellanova from University of Saint Louis. And the newcomer of the in the content committee, Jill Toll from the University of Amsterdam and the Racism Technology Center. Thank you to the EDRi team, and in particular to Angie Noni, who's been leading on this event. Thank you so much. This year, we're missing Guillermo Paris a lot, but we're also really happy to welcome Nevena Kripokavic-Martinovic to the EDRi team that you will see around. Here she is. Welcome, Nevena. And so, some practicalities. We have a safety team that is responsible also to act upon the community guidelines that you should have received. So, safety team people, if you're here, we have Nevena. Paige, I see you. Can you wave so that people can recognize you? Daniel, yeah, in the back. And if you don't know where these people are, you can always go to the reception center table, and they will direct you to these people. Lunch is served at 12:30 in the foyer, so please be on time. And remember that there are people with the red lanyards that do not want to be photographed or on camera. For these people as well, please be mindful about the location of the streaming cameras if you don't want to be on camera. And voila, that's it. We have now three sessions starting. So I will announce them, and then you'll have hosts introducing each sessions. Here in this room, we have the digital exclusion talk. In the boudoir, we have the discussion on health data. and in the salon, the discussions on down with data centers. So thank you very much. Enjoy the day, and I see you later.